Billy Meier claims to be contacted telepathically by space travelers from the constellation of the Pleiades. He is instructed to set up his camera in time to photograph craft that Meier calls the beam ships.
And these photographs are taken over a beautiful Swiss valley. They seem to show these objects coming in under conditions of broad daylight. But photo analysis shows, not surprisingly, that these are small objects not very far from the camera, apparently hung from a fishing pole line.
While Meier's visually compelling UFO films have made believers of many, skeptics have always considered them very suspicious. But now, newly discovered evidence reveals how Meier appears to have carried out the longest-running UFO hoax on record.
We know and can prove that he makes UFO models. He admits that. Having been to his property, you can see that he grows small trees. And lo and behold, when you look at his films, you see the same tree, in fact, in several of his films taken at different locations. That's impossible.
Investigative journalist Kal Korff has made several clandestine trips to Meier's Swiss farm to uncover his secret methods.
Meier uses small trees and models in a technique known as forced or false perspective, where you put the model in the tree very close to the camera. You have the house or the mountain in the background, and what you have basically is an optical illusion that to the trained eye isn't convincing.
Top Hollywood cinematographer Dean Cundey agrees.
If you watch the motion of the UFO, it is a pendulum kind of motion. Now, it's not a free-hanging pendulum. It's possibly a stiffer wire than maybe just monofilament. If you use a small model and suspend it a lot closer to the camera than you think, maybe 8 or 10 feet away, it allows you to create the illusion that the miniature is, in fact, a lot further away than it is.
Cundey sees even more elaborate rigging of a model behind this purported flying saucer caught on film.
Now, in this particular clip, it suddenly makes an appearance down here just above the horizon. Then it begins to move up, which would indicate that it's suspended on some kind of a clothesline rig or some kind of a device that relies on pulling on a rope or a line to get it to travel. And it appears to sort of hover up kind of nice and slowly, a little intermittently. What's interesting, though, is if you run it even backwards faster, you notice that it has sort of an oscillation, almost as if somebody's pulling on a rope.
Allegations that Meier uses clever trick photography to hoax his UFO footage have been made for years. And now, in this rare interview, Meier challenges his detractors to meet with him face to face.
Most people who attacked me never came and met me in person, never talked to me. They just either invented their photographic tests or reworked the tests of other people who had attacked me before. But they never bothered to investigate my case in person.
However, a person who knows Meier better than anyone else, his own ex-wife, Poppy Meier, also accuses him of being a blatant hoaxer. She points to his most recent UFO film as perhaps his most outrageous fake ever.
The truth is, my ex-husband is lying regarding the UFO affair. When I saw the UFO pictures that looked like a wedding cake, I asked myself, where did I see these lines before? This underpart! I realized it was a lid from a trash can. I compared the lid with the spaceship and identified these lines as being exactly what is on the lid.
Poppy Meier reveals that her ex-husband's skillful use of models and household implements is not only manipulative, but downright dangerous. She warns that he is using his faked UFO images to finance and promote a cult. Thousands of followers worldwide have flocked to Meier because they believe his message. Namely, that the end of the world is coming, and that his films prove he is the one chosen by aliens to help mankind survive. Meier's critics say he has his cult completely under his control.
Billy Meier is like a god to them.
This is a man who claims to be the Messiah. This is a man who tells you how to live your life, how many children you should have.
I'm going to show you some photos here. This photo is a photo of some of the core members of Billy Meier's group. As you can see, there's several of them. There's actually even more. This is a photo that I got in Switzerland years ago when I personally went there, one of several trips to investigate and expose the Meier case firsthand. And the issue and principle is about deception. You see, these people all trust Billy Meier. They trust him to not only tell them the truth, but they trust him to the point where they live their lives based on the directions and instructions that Billy Meier gives them. They even give at least 10% of their salary and time to Billy Meier. In other words, the Meier case is a little complicated in that it's not just a Swiss farmer faking a bunch of UFO photos. What it is here is a man who believes he has knowledge that can help the human race, and he may or may not, who knows. But instead of just saying, it's me, Billy Meier, I'm a farmer, here's my opinion, which of course wouldn't carry a lot of weight with a lot of people, what Meier does instead is he invents props. And what I mean by props is he fakes UFO photos and films, and then he fakes so-called contactee notes, where he says, hey, don't take this advice just from me, it's from the aliens, and if you follow them, everything will be okay. Well, that's a bunch of nonsense because there is no evidence that he's in touch with any advanced creatures from another world. In fact, the only evidence which can be measured and proven in a scientific laboratory, and we're one of many people who have done it, conclusively proves that the Meier case is a hoax.
Mr. Meier, when did the experiences begin?
The contact begins on January 28, 1975, in Hinwil.
Mm-hmm. How did it happen? What made you go outside into the forest?
I got something like a very nice voice in my head. I heard something to leave the house, to go out and to take a photo camera with me. So I left my house, and then when I was far outside from the village, I heard a singing noise in the sky, and when I was looking up there, I had seen a disc. This disc was flying over the clouds, and then it came to the point where I was staying with my motorcycle. Then slowly, slowly, it came slower and lower and settled down between the white trees and the forest there behind. Then I have seen a person who came out of the disc.
Person and, came out?
Yeah. And when the person came out of the left side of the trees there, I have seen that it is a woman.
Sitis apsi ja blondi. Dass das eben die Außerirdischen nicht können stimmen. Wenn ich jetzt das Buch vergleiche mit dem Bild vom Asket und das Bild vom Fernsehen, muss ich sagen, verblüffend. Man kann nicht sagen.
first words we turned and was going to this
tree here.
He walked over here?
Yeah.
How tall was he, Billy?
About 1 meter and 70 centimeter.
About like that? Show a little bit.
About like my size.
Ah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then he sit chest here and I here.
Sit down.
Ah.
Then you sat here and talked to her?
Yeah. Then we was talking here for about 1 hour or 1 hour and a quarter, something like that.
Did she give you a name? What did you call her?
Yeah, she told me her name is Semyase.
Semyase?
Yeah. You see, the first she told me I shall get the most best pictures of UFOs, what's ever happened on Earth.
These are actual photos that Billy Meier took in 1975. This is actually among the first photos, the first photos that he ever took of Semyase's so-called beam ship or Pleiadian spacecraft here. And what we're going to do is zoom in a little bit. And as you can see, this is one of his photos. And ladies and gentlemen, unlike the Meier group and unlike anybody else on the planet, I am the only person on this earth, literally, who has these original photos dating back to 1975. When I went undercover to Switzerland to expose the Billy Meier case as a hoax, because it is, I actually bought and scooped up all of the original photos that Billy Meier himself had directly given to his neighbors in order to try to convince them that what he was saying was true. And of course, he didn't convince a lot of people. In fact, a lot of people left his little group and wouldn't speak to him again. Now, to prove to you that this is the real thing, here's another photo that Meier took, and it is a hoax. So imagine this, folks. The very first photos that he took of his supposed first contact with Semyase are a fraud. I repeat, they are a fraud. They have been analyzed scientifically. These are the original prints given by Billy Meier himself. They date back to 1975. And as you can see on the back here, this is the actual Swiss writing that was written at the time. The yellow thing here is a piece of yellow tape. Now again, I am the only person on the planet with these images here. And as you can see, this UFO is also a hoax. It is actually made this way. What it is it's a photograph of two dinner plates inverted upside down with a cereal bowl on top of it, and it is what we call tabletop photography. And again, these are the original photos, folks. Billy Meier doesn't have them anymore.